Hello，我非常感谢 Jean-Philippe 的分享。那我觉得今天的主题非常有意思哦，因为过去我们谈 Open Data 比较多是从就是全国性的这样的 policy 的来谈。那今天两位呢，刚好都是从地方政府的角度来看这个资料，可以真的造成什么样实际的影响。
So and today, thank you for the wonderful sharing. Before that, usually open data, we would talk about more like close to national policy making. But now we can see some cases, interesting cases are from local government level. So thank you.
那我们也的确看到，就是说，像是刚才提到的交通主题这样子的一个从政府来做资料应用的 coach 这样子的一个模式在。他们在2013年就已经做了，那其实他有提到说，2009年，巴黎就在准备做这个 Open Data， 那台湾大概是到2012年底才开始有这个一些讨论。
Also regarding the mobility, actually the Paris city government, they've already engaged, like what you have seen, that in 2013, they have related services open, but they actually started the discussion and also the action in 2009, but in Taiwan, not until 2013, we start to have some discussion.
好，不过我还开始不见得是坏事哦，我们可能会后来居上。那我们今天非常高兴欢迎到这个桃园市政府的这个詹赫顺研考会主委。那因为其实台湾只有台北市有资讯局哦，那其他地方的这个资讯，就是做这些整合事情的，大概都是在这个研考会的业务下面。
But no worries. Latecomers doesn't necessary to be a late person. We might come up ahead, perhaps in the future. And also today, it is our honor to have He Shunzhan, the chairperson of the Research and Evaluation Commission from Taiwan City Government. Currently there is only one information department set up here at the local level, that is in Taipei City.And as for the rest of the local governments, it is usually the affairs and matters belonging to the Research and Evaluation Commission.
不过我刚被 update 了，其实桃园在3月15号的时候成立了这个
资讯局。
But the latest news is that actually there is an information department set up on March 15th in Taoyuan City Government.New.
好，所以我们可以看到桃园市真的非常的积极哦。那这个你常在各种场合讲到，就是说这个市长非常的厉害，所以应该是好。那我们就欢迎这个詹主委来分享桃园的一些经验，谢谢。
So we can see Taoyuan City Government and also the mayor of Taoyuan City Government is very active. So very impressive.Without further ado, let us welcome Chairperson He Shunzhan to give a remark.
大家午安。其实刚听完那个 Canon 讲的他们在巴黎做的事情，其实我们发现说，台湾市政府在开放资料的部分还是做得很少，因为我们现在只是把资料放到网络上去，可是其实人家资料放上去之后，已经把 API 甚至应用的功能都已经做完了，所以我们其实可以做的还更多。
After the sharing from Clement, we can see a lot of application and API already set up compared to the cases from Paris City Government. Taiwan City Government only put up the open data online, which means a lot of room to improve.
其实政府很早期在讲说我们要开放资料，然后又在谈开放政府。那其实我不是开放资料专家。我在，我也忘记我哪一年去参加居民的一个小小的专案，然后认识了谢友高，认识了 AU， 然后还认识了很多人，然后才开始慢慢接触 Open Data 这个领域。
And actually, we've always talking about open data over open governance, and myself is actually not an expert in these areas, but I forgot how many years ago, but.On one occasion, I met with Audrey and also Sarah Cao, and that's the start of my engagement.
So, today, actually, 我不是要讲说，我在 Open Data 在桃园做了多少，而是我想要谈的是，我怎么样利用我这样的一个身份，还有我自己的一些想法，去把桃园 Open Data 或者是在做数据分析这一块，怎么样把它打开来。
So today is not about what I did in Taiwan City Government, but to share about something, how I utilize my background and my ideas with matters related to Taiwan City Government.
我是去年的六月底到桃园市政府服务，那其实到今年的六月就快一年了。那其实大家可以看到这个表，就是不免俗的，我还是要介绍一下说，其实在桃园市政府开放资料的数量，其实在从去年的四月到今年三月，其实有大幅的成长。
And I was inaugurated last June and almost one year by now. And as you can see, actually starting from last April to March this year, we have significantly improved on the open data.
可是其实我们发现说，在这些 open data 的使用上面，最常被用的其实还是交通数据。
And actually, we can also see that the most frequently used open data set is about transportation.
那其实后来我们再去我自己也很无聊，我觉得这些数据应该可以拿出来做一些分析。但是因为分析了之后，我发现说，在同一个市政府里面，我们同样的一个栏位，它的标记的方式其实是不一样。例如性别，其实我们在市府里面就有三种格式，一个叫做男女，一个叫 MF， 另外一个叫10。那其实我也不知道为什么那个单位要用10来做代表。
And because sometimes I feel bored, so I will collect these data to analyze it. And I found very interesting fact that is we have no standardized form for the data. For example, when it comes to gender or sex, you have some it is called sex, male, female, or M or F, or 1 and 0.I don't know why it is differentiated with 1 and 0, but that's the fact.
所以这告诉我们说，其实在标准化这件事情上面，还有格式化这件事情是非常重要的。
So that tells us how important it is to standardize the format.
那这些资料跟市政治理有什么关系？其实，因为我不是一个资料科学的专家，我也不是一个 open data 的专家，所以我是用一个市民的立场去思考这件事情。所以其实，我是建立在这两个点上面，一个叫想象，你要想象我的资料可以做什么事情；另外一个是我在公部门里面怎么样驱使同仁去实践这件事情。
And when it comes to data versus city governance, because I'm not expert in data or data management or open data, so I think of it as a citizen, and to see, for example, what's the imagination from our citizens to expect for our government, and to push the fellow colleagues in city government to perform certain actions.
那其实在这过程当中，我们发现说，民间跟政府的想象其实是完全不一样的。那身为一个政务官，在负责这件事情上面，其实我们应该去找到那个平衡点，让这件事情可以很顺利的去进行。
And then I realized that there is actually a gap between the expectations from the citizens and from the city government. So,it's our job to find how we can balance between the two.
好，刚刚我提到说那个标准跟格式很重要，因为我们做了一个桃园市政府的 open data 的研究，所以就发现说其实我们的标准跟格式是没有的。那我们就再做统一这件事情。
So, because we now realize how important it is to have standards and formats.And then, after reviewing the data opened by Taiwan City Government, we realized actually there's no standards and or format whatsoever.
那因为过去大家都会强调那个 KPI, 所以就会去讲 KPI, 大家就会去追求那个 开放资料的那个量，但都忘记其实资料的值是很重要的。当你有量，你的值不好的时候不好用，那它其实就是一个无效资料。
We often talk about KPIs, and usually we set up KPIs for everything. So when it comes to open data, usually we're in pursuit of the quantity of the open data. But with the poor quality, the open data is basically invalid.
所以在去年开始，我们在桃园市的 open data， 我们在求的是值的部分。大家可以看到，就是从一星的 PDF， 大家如果大家在玩 open data 就知道说，你拿到 PDF 就是件很痛苦的事情。像当年我参加那个专案，就拿 PDF 的时候，我就想吐，因为你想要做任何事情都不能做，要重提一遍。那其实我们就是在往五星的方向。那去年开始，我们尽可能都在试出的时候就要先达到三星的水准。
Starting from last year, actually we try to move upward. As you can see, we have several formats. Usually, a lot of people will get the files of PDF. So, and when I get a file of PDF in different projects, I will feel like very sick of it, because you can basically hard to utilize it. You have to key in everything manually after you get the files. So now we want to move upward to the five-star part. In the short term, we try to manage it to get it to the three-star.
那其实我们在几个县市的部分，因为大家都有这样的共识，因为大家其实都有在办黑客松，那其实都有在做资料的整理。其实我们跟桃园跟竹竹苗，我们现在也在讨论说，明年我们希望可以把四个县市的交通以及观光的资料做一个整合跟整理，那可以开放出来让更多的人使用。
And there are a lot of hackathon events happening here around Taiwan, and we also utilize that. And currently, we're working with the governments of Hsinchu and Miaozhu and Miaoli to share data regarding transportation and tourism.
其实在今年我也在我们的公务的网站上面开始推 Open API。那因为 Open API 的网站其实在制作上对同仁可能是有点新，但是我觉得这是未来的趋势。那我们就是定立说，只要是市府新做的网站，都应该要把 Open API 的概念放进去，而不是让它就是一个公开的网站的资料，大家还要使用传统的复制贴上的这样的做法。毕竟这些资料它都是可以被使用的，那我们应该让它变得更方便被使用。
And recently, we're promoting the concept of Open API, but it's a relatively new idea for the colleagues in city government. But now we still think it is a trend for the future. So whenever there's a new platform, online platform or website set up, we'll push for the idea of Open API, because so that in the future we don't have to always copy and paste, we can just port the idea, port the data easily.
刚有提到说，市民想要什么？那我是一个市民，我想要知道什么？其实我想要知道的就是说，我在这个县市，我家附近的工程，重大工程，它的进度是什么？那接下来讲比较有趣的案例，就是，以图像式的方式来呈现说重大工程的进度，桃园市应该是第一个，因为过去大部分都是用文字的形式。
Because a lot of things for example, we now utilize a lot of visual presentation to present the open data from the city government. For example, sometimes we will see citizens will want to know the construction nearby my place, the progress of it, how does it progress, and what's the condition of it. This is the open data we have, and probably we're one of the first to present it in a visual way of the open data instead of the traditional conventional way of texts.
大家可以看到，这是我们中央建设进度的网站。那其实这个是在原本我们的广考系统里面，它是不被公开的。但是因为，我自己的想象，我觉得这是很重要的事情，所以我就是告诉市长说，市长，我们可不可以来开放重大工程建设进度，让民众来知道？那他也觉得说，哎，这本来就是应该让市民知道。其实是议员在监督，市民也要一起监督。那其实当你的资讯越公开越透明的时候，其实对于市府的效率来讲，其实某种的提升。
And this is actually it's about the major construction progress of Taiwan City Government. Usually, this kind of system is already embedded and existed in the research and evaluation system within the government, but not disclosed to the public.So when I talked to the mayor, said that it is very important to open the data for the public, and so that it will facilitate the whole process and improve the efficiency of the governance of the city government.
当你点进去之后，你选择了某一项工程，它就会以长条图的方式来告诉你说，现在它的规划跟施工还有验收的进度以及期程是多少。那其实这个在公开之前呢、啊，我们应该是说，我受到很多局处的压力，就是说，主委可不可以不要公布那个日期，可不可以公布已完成的？那其实我的回复就是说，第一，你已完成的公布在这边干嘛？它是进度表、啊。第二，你不给我日期的话，你不给民众日期的话，民众怎么会知道？你都可以开记者会讲说，我这个预计什么时候完工，那我为什么不能把它写在这个表上面？
And this you can see, this is the like a bar map to show the progress of the major constructions of Taiwan City Government. Before we're doing that, actually I got a lot of pressure from within because they will say that is it possible that we just put up those projects that are finished already, not the one that is ongoing.Then I replied that, well, there is no difference because actually you held conferences, press conference telling when you finish the projects or complete the constructions. And I'm simply just put up the dates you already mentioned onto the website. That's it.
因为我刚刚提到我的工作是要找到市府跟市民之间的一个平衡点，所以最后我们大概有挑了几个时间点把它放上去，那大家可以，大家一定会有会注意到说，那现在实际的进度在哪里？对，你看不到，但是我们有文字叙述，你算的话可以算出来那个现在是落后还是超前的。
And of course, as I have mentioned, we try to find a balance between the citizens and the government, and therefore we come up with this chart.You can see actually we have the progress and the bars, but with no definite date of completion. But we have text. So if you calculate with the text and the graphs, you can actually see when the exact date should be completed and whether it is delayed or on schedule.
如果大家想看的话，就是可以查询那个桃园市政府重大建设计划 ，Google 它就会出现了。
So if you are interested, you can just simply Google the major constructions of Taiwan City Government, then you'll see the platform.
好，时间快到，我讲快一点。其实后面我们就是其实接下来我讲的案例，其实我们是把很多 open data， 有一些是在中央开放的社政情资料，然后另外是我们自己在。府内做的 GIS 平台，把这些资料跟图资做一个套叠，那可以提供我们在决策上做的更精准。
And next, I will talk about more because a lot of open data are already shared by the central government, and also some data open by the local government level. So we try to put the data and map it to the maps.Of the existing map or integrated the open data together with the GIS decision making platform.
大家可以看到这张图，其实就是这个区里面的人口的密度，就是用颜色的深浅来做分别。那这一张图呢，其实我们把 交通事故的资讯整合到我们的地图 GIS 地图上面，就可以看得出来，就红色的部分就是交通事故发生密度高的地方。那这个也可以让提供给警察局做一个参考，是他在执勤的时候，或是在上下班车流多的时候，他该注意哪几个路口。
And previous picture you can see is actually the population density demonstrated with different levels, different colors together. And this one is that we integrated the traffic incidents onto the map, onto the GIS system, so that you can see the frequency and the hotspots of the accident happens, so that our colleagues can be more careful when it comes to traffic.
其实这个图也是一样，它是另外一个案例。大家如果印象桃园的时候轮胎厂大火的时候，我们也是利用这一套系统去算出来说，它周边方圆几公尺里面可能会受到影响。那如果有登记在市府的这些公寓、管委会大楼的资讯，或者是学校，我们都会及时的通知他们要注意这个情况。
And previously, if you remember, there was a big fire from a tire factory, which is quite the impact of it is quite immense.And we utilize the GIS system to calculate the radius of it, the radius of the impact. And if you are a registered community commission or the registered schools we can, on the system, we can inform all these parties regarding the impact of the radius.
其实在我们这个平台上面的资料啊，它其实都是Open data 都是公开的，我们都是从各单位接进来。那唯一没有公开的是那个 GIS 的图。其实我们现在也在考虑说，未来 GIS 的图是不是有可能，或者是我们这个平台是有可能把它开放出来，让民众大部分的人都可以使用。
And basically, there are a lot of data are already open from the different agency of the government.The only thing that is not open yet to the public is the graph or the map of the GIS system. So perhaps in the future we're still thinking about whether we can open the map and the information of the map to the public as well.
最后其实这个其实小结是给自己跟给政府单位啊，就是说第一个是，其实政府应该要先问自己有哪些资料可以开放出来的，而不是去问民众或者是问这些开放社团说，你希望我开放什么资料？因为可能有很多资料是不能被开放的。那我们要自己先思考过说有哪些资料可以开放，那怎么样开放，然后开放到什么程度？我觉得这都是可以讨论跟沟通的。
And here is my conclusion for the sharing session. First will be, as a government, we can actually start thinking what kind of data we can open to the public, not passively to ask the open society or the community what kind of data you need and want, because there is some data is confidential and not to be open. So we can actually to see first what kind of data we can open.
那第二个是，其实我们在做开放资料，应该是从市民的立场，或者是说我们要做开放政府的时候，应该是从市民的立场去思考，说市民想要知道什么，而且他有权利知道什么，那我们要去提供给他。
And the second is that we should also think or put ourselves into the shoes of the citizens to see what kind of things they want to know.Or what's their expectations and how they will react, so that we can see how we can provide services to our citizens.
那第三个其实就是我到市府以后一直在跟同仁沟通的一件事情，说开放其实是在释放大家的压力，而不是造成大家的压力。
And the third thing is that openness is actually.I've been talking to the fellow colleagues of the city government that is, openness is actually releasing the pressure, not creating pressure.
因为当资讯越透明越公开的时候，其实他的疑问，我自己认为他的疑问是相对会减少的。那其实就像 研考会在负责的1999跟市政信箱的业务是一样的。当他的资讯越多越公开的时候，其实那1999电话的量，我有发现他好像会开始慢慢的降低。那可是其实1999的资料有很多可以玩的地方，那我们最近也在玩一些新的东西。
And because the more transparent your government is, the less problems and issues that will come after. For example, we have citizen hotline 1999 and citizen mailbox. If you become more transparent, actually the complaint from the citizen hotline or the mailbox is reducing. So it's actually beneficial. And regarding the citizen hotline, there is also some interesting things we can play with.
如果等一下 panel 还有机会的话，我可以讲一下1999我们最近在玩的新玩意。然后今天的分享就先到这边，谢谢。
So perhaps later in the panel discussions, if we have time, I can share more about the things we've been playing with the citizen hotline 1999. So that's it for my sharing session. Thank you.